people.
Okay, all right.
Go out and get some speed, baby.
Right. I understand. Well, the Terrapins will get the football to start the second half. And Josh Wilson, the nightmares for him. A couple of fumbles for the veteran return. This time he wraps his arms around the football and comes up with a short return out near the 25. Let's go to Aaron Andres.
Chris, I had a chance to speak with Maryland head coach Ralph Friedgen on his way out from the locker room. He said, say all you want about making adjustments at this point. Look at the score. He said, all we discussed at half was heart. That's what it all comes down to. He was actually happy with his quarterback, Sam Holland, back. He said he thought he played well and kept it up down the stretch. I said, what do you have to do against Slayton and White? And he said, pray, bring out the rosary, you name it. I don't know.
Hey, Kirk, do you think he brought up the name Frank Reich at halftime? Remember the Maryland quarterback? Go 31-0 down at Miami.
It's on Classic all the time.
Came back and won that game for the Terrapins before he engineered the big comeback with the Bills against the Oilers. Well, a lot of work to do if they're going to try to get back in this one. And Lance Ball, a short carry over the left side for about two. Not a real explosive offense. I mean, it hasn't been. It's kind of methodical.
Yeah, you know, it is methodical, but I've been impressed with Hollenbach, the quarterback, considering the circumstances, the fact he got down 28-0. He's had to throw the football when West Virginia's defense has known it. But I've been really pleased with the way he sat in the pocket and made some pretty good decisions, and he's not giving up. That's the most important thing for a quarterback to lead his team when you get down by such a big margin.
Well, no doubt. That touchdown drive, though, took 8 minutes, and they can't afford the long marches. They run the option, and Keon Lattimore takes the pitch and kind of squirms for two.
Well, that's kind of the Achilles heel of this offense of Maryland's at this stage of the game. Big, strong offensive line, maybe the best ever under Ralph Friedgen. Quarterback that's kind of a veteran, that it's a good leader. Tight ends are solid. It comes down to, can Isaiah Williams on the outside, Okendo on the outside, Hayward Bay, when Weatherly gets healthy, can these receivers give them enough of a threat to get vertical?
Hayward Bay to the top of your screen. Okendo and Williams split to the right on third and six. Hollenbach flips it across, caught by Hayward Bay. Shows his
offensive line giving Hollenbach time to throw.
He's going to be mad at you. You said 4-4. They clocked him at 4-2.
I'm sorry.
4-3.
Well, we could use that speed, so it's a 4-1 last I heard for Maryland.
Call a receiver 4-4 these days. That's slow. Hollenbach deep down the sidelines, well defended and intercepted. But now they're going to talk about it and say it's a double catch. Holmes pointing his direction. The official ran across the field and
Chris,
the receiver had it.
Well, there's confusion, and it's going to come down to who had possession when their bodies simultaneously hit the turf. Great position by Lewis to get just completely used his body to push the receiver Hayward Bay to the outside. He high pointed the ball, giving up about 3 or 4 inches. It's just going to be a matter of who they decide had the ball when they
rolling
came
on the
down.
Field is that the defender had control of the ball, came to the ground. Therefore, it's an interception.
Useful as far as game experience, pretty excited there. And as I said, he take away the fact that there was a little bit of a dispute on whether or not he made the interception. He put himself in great position there to make the play.
Now let's see if this Mountaineer offense can get back in sync. So brilliant in the first quarter, sluggish, self-destructive with penalties in the second quarter when they had only 26 yards in that quarter. This is White on the keeper. Cuts back, dances around, loses the football himself, and it looks like the Terrapins have recovered. And again, this is a very talented West Virginia team, but it's still a young one. And White just a sophomore, as is Slayton. It's pretty heady stuff to be ranked number 5 and blowing a team out in your home field on national TV. They have not really responded that well since building the lead. And Lance Ball follows a block to the right for a nice game.
Ralph Friedgen decides to use his replay, loses a timeout, and they catch a break by getting the turnover almost right exactly where Hayward Bay would have made the reception.
Right.
So, as fate would have it, it has a unique way of working itself out. And now Ralph Friedgen has to come up with a few plays here where he's going to come up with 7 points. He cannot walk away from here without 7 points.
Okendo, the only receiver set wide as they use two tight ends. Ball in the I formation, gets it, cuts it back, barrels up the middle, and finds the end.
front by the Terrapin offensive line.
They tack on the point, so the Terrapins.
Never say die out of Maryland.
Well, if they had not given up.
Field, fellas, that one's on me. My bad. Let's kind of regroup here. Let's get back to playing the kind of football we've been playing for most of this night.
Really positive play for West Virginia since they built that big lead was a kickoff return for a touchdown by Raynaud, who has this one and gets tripped up across the
the hand of West Virginia, or if West Virginia keeps slicing and dicing, getting right down the field.
First down throw for White, who flips it.
Taste in their mouth how they had been talking about this game since the summertime. Means a lot to them.
And just tripping and falling. After the handoff is Slayton, who'll lose about four, and all of a sudden,
well, that's what I'm saying. This drive is huge. Going back to the point that Aaron made, 5-6 last year, 5-6 the year before that. That's following Ralph Regan's first 3 years, where they won 10 games in those first 3 years. All the bad taste in their mouth is right, and they want to try to show that whether they win this game or not, they've got the fight and the character to hang in this game. It's a big third down.
It was 10 wins per season, actually 33 wins in those first 3 years. These guys on this year's team came in on the heels of that kind of success, but haven't been able to achieve it. So on third and long, White lofts it down the sidelines and unable to run under it is Brandon Miles, a 4.37 guy. Gardner there on the coverage, so a punt.
Well, the last two series, big for Maryland's defense to come out and start the second half, not only forcing West Virginia, in this case, to punt, the previous series, the turnover. But look at the clock. Absolutely no time taken off the clock and giving Maryland's offense the ball again here. And we're really not even 5 minutes into the third quarter.
Only the second punt of the evening for Scott Kozlowski, the freshman. Varner and Okendo are deep. High kick. It's Varner who let it bounce. Didn't quite get there in time, and it bounds out of bounds at the 37-yard line. So West Virginia, after the furious start, begins to struggle a bit. Some penalties, a turnover, their first of the year, and now Maryland, a nice three and out. And here we go. We'll see how much fight the Terrapins have left. Still, as you said, plenty of time, Kirk.
All of a sudden, we're seeing a quarterback in Sam Hollenbach getting more and more comfortable. Last series was important for Maryland and their defense to get the ball back. Now we'll see what Sam Hollenbach can do with about, you know, over 60 yards to try to move the ball down the field.
The tight end, Hanos, on the right side of the formation. They hand it off to Lattimore out of the I formation, short gain.
8-24, then it becomes interesting. This is a big drive, obviously.
Hollenbach flips it over the middle, caught by Hayward Bay, who had first down yardage, kind of ran back. Media market, not in love with what's going on there the last couple of years. On third and short, they hand it off to Lattimore, and he barrels ahead first down at midfield.
Masterful play action game.
We flip it out to Lattimore in the flat. A couple of nice blocks.
Authority, it's great between he and Lance Ball. It's again provided the Terrapins with a nice tandem in the backfield.
This time he tries to turn the corner on the right, nothing doing. Good job by the Mountaineer defense to string it out 4 yards. In the pursuit, John Holmes and Bobby Hathaway there. Aaron, we are seeing an inspired Keon Lattimore tonight.
Absolutely. Chris, you mentioned the knock on him being indecisive. I was told actually at the beginning of the year he had a sit down with Ralph Regan, said, I'm not happy. I'm not happy with the way I'm playing. I'm not happy with the way you're playing me. Regan basically gave him a talk and said, you got to show me more, guy. And that's what he's doing.
Well, he's going to rotate in there with Ball and with Josh Allen, but it's been increasingly Lattimore's show tonight. Hollenbach hits it as he throws and fires over the middle, incomplete. Mark Magro, the linebacker, there to pressure.
It's the beauty of this 3-3-5 defense is disguising the blitz. Looks like it's coming from the middle at the last second. Ball is snapped, and the linebackers and the safeties come from the outside. That time, the offensive line did not pick up the pressure, and Hollenbach didn't have a chance to be able to find anybody to try to pick up that first.
Adlesh to punt, and Antonio Lewis, who had the interception a few minutes ago, signals for a fair catch right at the 10-yard line. So Maryland's defense once again has to step up for field position for the Mountaineers after the 40. White hands off, running room for Slayton. Out to the 45-yard line. That's more like it. His last four carries, Kirk, had netted 0 yards. That's more like the Slayton in the first quarter.
Well, this time they're going in a position away from the safety. We talk about Maryland walking their safeties up. Walk a safety up this time. They run away from him. Great check there by the coaching staff on the sideline, giving Steve Slayton some running room. And now here they go. They're trying to create some tempo to get their offense going.
34 yards that time for Slayton, this time a hard-earned two. Conrad Bolston on the tackle.
West Virginia in their spread offense believes in tempo. They have three different speeds that they run their no huddle. The regular personnel, and of course they have their indie personnel, and then the jet. And you can see the first quarter, 230 yards, averaging almost 11 yards per snap. And since then, prior to that big run by Steve Slayton, have not done very much.
And Slayton's 15th carry, he reaches the 200-yard mark. This time White on the keeper. Knifing through the defense. Pat White inside the 10. They can turn it on in a hurry after a sluggish couple of possessions. Their first turnover of the season. White, Slayton atoning for that.
Great blocking downfield. Look at the offensive line. Look at these blocks at the second level by these offensive linemen of West Virginia. And look at the running lane. It's a simple quarterback lead there. And the speed of Pat White with the blocking getting of the offensive line getting that second level. You cannot allow him to get into space or he'll make you pay for it.
First and goal. They pitch it back. Slayton trying to pick his way, showing that patience and bullying inside the five and brought down late. The crowd wants a flag as Covington was there. No flag.
It's funny, we're up here sensing a little bit of a law for West Virginia. Aaron Andrews talked about it downstairs, and Rich Rodriguez, I think, felt the same thing at 38-17. They hadn't gotten anything going in their first two possessions. He said, we're going to get out there, and we're going to go. We're going to get our tempo going, create a little bit of momentum for this offense, and within a couple, two or three plays, he go 85 yards and all the way to the other end of the field.
He had the entire group of starters huddled over there before the kickoff, sending that message. Message received. Second and goal from the four. Slayton again. Stutter steps, but nowhere to go.
Slayton on the carry.
Nice job filling in there by Dre Moore, the nose tackle.
I think we're seeing a difference in Pat White. As I said, everybody wants to say, can he throw the ball? How's he improved? This is him after the turnover in the second half that led to a Maryland touchdown. He says, my bad to the defense. Now with a chance to make some plays to try to give his offense a shot to be able to get points on the board, getting the ball all the way down to the 5-yard line.
Third and goal. White trying to squirm ahead. He's stopped at the 2-yard line. Crowd immediately starts yelling, go.
Of course.
Well,
it's a big call here.
It's a valid point they make. Up by 21 inside of 5 minutes in the third quarter. If you don't get it, you leave the football about 99 yards away. And the crowd approves. No kicker on the field.
And he's got a nice lead with a shot to go for the knockout punch right here. On the other hand, if you're Maryland, this is do or die for this defense.
They'll call a timeout. You see the play clock winding down here. So just maybe they haven't been able to convince Coach Rye yet to go for this. We'll find out when we come back.
West Virginia. Timeout.
Well, Slayton, although he's reached 200 yards, still has a ways to go. We've had some outstanding single-game rushing efforts in the good backs have been over the years. Amos Zaraway, Coburn. Notice that East Carolina was the opponent for K.J. Harris's game a couple years ago and for Coburn's big 260-yard game. You know, the next opponent for West Virginia will be the Pirates of ECU. So he didn't get the record tonight. Another chance next week. Like,
well, I love all those backs. But the best back that it is only his sophomore year that I've seen in Morgantown is number 10, Steve Slayton. You know, it's early in his career, Chris, but he has a chance to knock off a lot of those numbers if they keep him in the game long enough. You look at the schedule and who they have to play, some of their marquee matchups. Thursday night football, we're going to get a chance to see him a couple more times. And the game at Louisville, I think a lot of people think, could decide the Big East Championship and a BCS bowl right.
Circle November 2nd. Michael Bush out or not, Louisville has plenty of weapons. Of course, the Cardinals have the big game against Miami this weekend. That's the biggest non-conference test for any Big East school. The Cardinals are favored at home over Miami, but it'll be a lot of fun. Yeah,
with all the talk early in the year about Troy Smith and Brady Quinn and even Pat White, two quarterbacks to get overlooked play in this conference in the Big East. Tyler Bocco at Pittsburgh, who they take on Michigan State in a big game, big fan of his, and Brian Brohm down at Louisville, who we'll get a chance to see a couple times. He is, and now that he's healthy and recovered from his knee, a great NFL prospect.
Well, they've talked about it, and they're still going for it. Slayton in the I formation, set behind 250-pound Owen Schmidt. They need two full yards here. White's got it, and he's got a touchdown. So West Virginia caps a real nice drive. The two-yard touchdown run from Pat White, the 38th rushing touchdown in the last 10 games. That's incredible. That's vintage Oklahoma-Nebraska stuff. That really is.
That is.
He averaged almost 4 rushing touchdowns per game over a 10-game span. A 90-yard drive. Half done. And fourth down run by White. And one more time, McAfee.
And you got to love the call on the way they use his athletic ability to roll him to the outside, because he has that ability to run and throw. Once again, Pat White leading the Mountaineers to a big score.
They love their football in these parts. Great tradition at West Virginia. Going back to Sam Huff in the back in the day. And that Mountaineer is getting a workout, running out of ammunition tonight, too. That musket.
Working those tries, looks like you, babe.
There's old Sam Huff. Oh, yeah. That was some hard-nosed football.
Oh, man. Knock you out.
And a short kickoff from McAfee. And it's Noah Carroll fielding it from Maryland. He'll be stopped short of the 20-yard line. Yeah, about 4 minutes ago on the clock, we were saying, yeah, this offense sputtering, sluggish a little bit. I think they found some high octane, and they refueled and got going.
Yeah, in the last 6 games, they've kept refueling, because you look at what they've been able to do per game. This is on the ground. I want to see if anybody can get into the face of this West Virginia offense this year and challenge them physically and athletically. Who's willing to put 8 guys up front and say, Pat White and Steve Slayton, you cannot beat us by running the football? Can anybody match up with them and challenge them? Because you've got to be skilled on the perimeter to be able to do that.
Holland back. Handing off to Lance Ball. He didn't have the speed to turn the corner there as Holmes, who's been very active tonight, the strong safety.
Again, the only knock that you ever hear on a West Virginia offense is, can they throw the ball if they have to?
Right.
And I'll continue to say, why? Why do they have to? Patrick White tonight is only 6 of 9. But again, until somebody shows them consistently that you're going to take away their run, I mean, they're averaging over 350 yards a game on the ground.
Well, Maryland knew they were going to run the football.
Yeah.
That last drive, though,
yeah.
Boom. Slayton for 34, White for 47.
Just happened so fast.
It's short field.
Yeah.
Tight end set back, and once again it's Hanos with a short catch over the middle.
Mouth, because of the tempo that they create, it's very difficult on a defense to practice that, prepare for the speed and aggressiveness of that offense.
third and four. Hayward Bay in motion. Hollenbeck looks right there, finds him, fighting towards the first down yardage near the 30.
Hollenbeck's pass complete to Darius Hayward Bay.
I think right now they're going to have to just try to stretch this defense out and make a big play through the air.
Hayward Bay, the speedster, set to the right side. Hollenbeck instead throws short for Hanos one more time. Castile also coaches the linebackers. He's in his sixth year here. It has taken over as the coordinator as they hand it off to Latimer up the middle. He finds running room and bowls near midfield and into West Virginia territory. So Latimer continues to run inspired.
Gang defense, just a bunch of jerseys flying around and trying to make a play together because they don't have those individual standout players.
Latimer follows up Maryland's longest run of the night, 16 yards with about six more there.
But I think that's why they've instituted this 3-3-5. It gives them an unusual look. Not many offenses that prepare to see West Virginia are used to seeing it. So their offense is a little bit different, and their defense is a little bit different. Because they don't have the marquee athletes, they have to have kind of an unusual oddball look defense.
So 45 minutes in the books.